I can accept losing 5 seconds, maybe even 10 seconds in episodes 1 and 2, but it's a stretch. That's why I like to practice the later episodes ahead of time in a stream. Even if the run resets halfway through, then I'll still have shown most of the game. The signpost. Turrets start firing a set time after they have loaded, and they load when you're close to them on the map. Therefore, you can usually ignore the turrets entirely. There's a swiveling trick on the spikes. If you hold down jump and are not going at full speed, if you let go of the key, then you do not take damage in the spikes. It's a strange effect, but it works like this. You can use as many launchers here as you want. You don't need them anymore after this level. That was a good kill. It's very nasty to kill that sword. If you miss that invulnerability, it's still fine. Don't have to backtrack and get it. The boss shifts phase to that drilling phase halfway through the fight, depending on his hit points. Yeah, toasters have a good chance at hitting that one. Still, it's hard to hit. D9 launchers is still more than enough. I'll need them at the end of Techno R2. Ah. That's good. That's very sharp. That was almost too early, but I snatched the spring still. Very good. Beautiful stage. I swivel there back and forth to hit the ditch trigger at all costs. That wasn't perfect. I didn't get hit. Good. Platforms were not in the way. Excellent Orbitus. Excellent episode 2 in general. Ah. Okay, fine, we're back on track after hitting the red spring there. With one shield, I'll spend it deliberately here, even though I could jump over the flower, to have a better chance at damage boosting later here. Kill all of this and then damage boost in a very controlled manner of that plant. Thank you. Oh, perfect. And don't even have to jump to the carrot. Now this is fine. We'll lose some time in funnel lint because I'm running against a medium funnel lint. We should leverage the choice of heart in this map from the fast feed. Nice. Fast feed on heart go at 12 pixels per frame instead of the medium feed that go at 10 pixels per frame. Wow. Nice, wow, this is the early spring. If you run out of launchers here, it's fine. Usually if you look down, you don't hit any of those rockets. The biggest mistake in the 2801 is in Mega Base, and since the Mega Base has been going extremely, extremely well, I expect to be at around minus 8. Or even better. Ideally, I take damage there. Makes it much safer. Oop. Okay, that is new. Fine. That should be enough RF missiles. You could stop there and get more, but I don't think it's necessary. Nice. Oi, I almost jumped into that red beetle. That can happen if you jump too often. And now we'll go for the risky maneuver. There, nice. Launching that last beetle is super hard. Selection there to take the RF missiles. I think it's optimal because I can't mesh that quickly. Oh, that's bad. Okay, it didn't hit anything and it didn't lose much. Great. That boost is not optimal, but it's safest for me because I find it very hard to stop jumping with down and jump there. I shot it with toasters, I believe. I'm not sure. Toasters have the biggest chance of hitting the signpost. That happens occasionally, but it's really rare. It's the reason I choose launchers in the first place. To hit the fast feet. Ooh, too early. You don't even have to jump. The jump is a mistake. It cannot improve the run because with fast feet, your slope speed is the same, jumping or not jumping. You get launchers here for that. I like to shoot that switch here with the launchers. It's the best weapon in my opinion. Also here. Yeah, let's do this boost for once. Nice, that's a good backup. This run still has potential, therefore I will not take the carrots and instead play it as risky as possible. I might die. If I die, it's over in one shot. Don't waste the RF missiles. I killed a little owl mainly to be in the best spot for camera alignment. Yeah. I almost jumped too high and would have jumped into the spikes. Perfect. Okay, this is the optimal way for Pez Rock. Beautiful Pez Rock button. Do I do the risky boost? Yeah, of course. Ah. Okay, in this case we'll ride the platform and it's good. It's okay, it's okay. That's not okay. Thank you. this springboard, you do not want to hit it. Variant of that jump, but I still don't have a setup for the good variant. The boss is not optimal, but it still is the 27XX. Nice. hi Alexis. Hi Carlito. Everybody's been watching. Yeah, it's the sub 28. GG, thanks. The beginning was not optimal, but that's fine. The episode 1 was very sharp in the PB, in the earlier PB, and now it's only mediocre. Episode 2 is very good in both the old run and this run, and episode 3 is splendid. Excellent episode 3, 2 golds with the hard mode, and after that it's shepherding this advantage home, and that's it.